Welcome to video number 6 of Articy's First Steps tutorial series. In this video, we will create our first mission, introduce global variables as trackers for quests and events, and use basic scripting to query variable values and change them. Let's dive right in. Submerge into the first mission node with the Enter hotkey. The layout of the mission consists of a small cutscene depicting a spaceport and a flight to the moon, the moon node itself, where we will add everything that happens on the surface, another cutscene for the flight back, and a quest wrap-up dialogue with Mrs. Peabody. It is hard to distinguish what all these elements stand for if they all look the same. We can change the color of a node from the toolbar, but then we need to do it one by one and always have to remember the correct color for the selected node type. A more elegant solution would be to use templates. We need templates for cutscenes, events, quest parts, and location fragments. But before we create them, we will start with some features we can use in a couple of these templates. I'd like to have the information if the event can happen only once or multiple times, and in what situations it will fire up or trigger. For example, in our game, an event could start as soon as a player enters a specific area of the map. Another one when they have the correct item in their inventory. The functionality itself will be created in the game engine later, but at this point we can already prepare necessary data with Articy. Here I use a drop-down menu to list all possible trigger types for events, locations, quests, skills, etc. And a slot, where I can connect a respective object as a reference. Again, this will make life easier when working in the game engine, as we already establish object connections here in Articy. For the location fragment feature, I only need a reference to the location itself, to create an easy-to-follow connection between flow fragment and location. I know that the reference here should always point to a location, so I can set a narrow constraint to avoid referring to any other object type by mistake. Now let's do the templates with the features we just created. All these templates will be for flow fragments. Therefore, we navigate to the flow fragment template subfolder. Drag the feature or features to the content area, and don't forget to select color and icon for your template, so you can easily distinguish nodes in the flow editor later, or in the hierarchy view of the navigator. Back to the flow. First, we assign a new template to our nodes. Like so often, you can use the toolbar or the right-click menu to do this. If we want to access the properties of this node, we have multiple ways to accomplish that. Via the toolbar, the right-click context menu, or with the F8 hotkey. I just set it to a single time event and return to the flow editor. Cutscenes will combine text and pictures to show parts of the storyline. The surface of the moon is where the action will take place. Therefore, we submerge into this node. Do you remember the hotkey? Enter. Like entering the node to go deeper. On the moon, we will have one event, a cutscene and a quest part, which both will be triggered by entering a specific zone. When triggered, cutscene and quest display some text, which we can enter directly in their nodes. The node for the Tasty Rocks event functions as a container. The content will be nested within. The player will be able to find a spot of tasty moon rocks, and Janosch, the pet, can eat some of them. The plan is that the player is able to visit this place more than once, but after eating once, Janosch is full. How can we control this? How do we tell Articy and later the game engine that the player will experience the event differently, depending if it's their first visit or a consecutive one? The answer is variables. Click on Global Variables in the navigator and choose Create New Variable Set from the toolbar. A variable set is like a folder for a number of variables. we will call the set game state. Now we can start creating variables. Global variables in Articy can either be Boolean or integer. Boolean variables can store a true or false value. For example, does the player have the quest item? Yes or no. This kind of variable might seem very limited on first glance, but it is a valuable tool and will be used a lot in our project. Integers are whole numbers that can be positive, negative, or zero. 21 and -12 are integers. 3.5 is not. I start with a variable called credits. Please keep in mind that variable names must be usable in code. Therefore, they have the same constraints as technical names of objects, no spaces or special characters. In this variable, we will store Lily's wealth. As we want to store an actual amount, it needs to be of type integer. The default value will be 0. That means that at the start of the game, Lily does not have any money on her at all. Another variable we need for the first mission is a quest tracker, just so that we can see if the quest objective has been completed or not. It will be of type Boolean. And last but not least, we create another Boolean variable as a tracker for the Tasty Rocks event. To be able to use Articy's built-in scripting support, make sure the entry is checked in the Flow tab of the project settings. Now we can go back to the Tasty Rocks event in the Flow editor. In this case, it is not the player who decides which branch will be chosen. The narrative will continue automatically, depending on the state of the variable we created for this event. To check the state of a variable, we need a so-called condition. Conditions are checked at the start of a node. They always go into the input pin. Only if the statement of the condition is true, the node will be played. Double-click the input pin of the first visit node to open the edit window. The game is supposed to choose this path only on the first visit, on which our variable still has the starting value. The default value when creating a Boolean is false, so we need to phrase the condition to reflect this. Start typing variable set.variable, which in our case is gameState.tastyRocksTracker, and the autocomplete should kick in. Then two equality signs false. It is important to keep in mind that for a condition check you always need to use two equality signs, which is called an equality operator. How do we change the variable value after we went through the first visit node? To change a variable, we need an instruction. Instructions always run at the end of a node. We put instructions into the output pin. Double-click the pin and enter the same variable name again. This time we want to assign a value. Therefore, we need to use the assignment operator. An assignment operator consists of one equality sign. We need to type variable set.variable assignment operator true. All that is missing now is a condition on the input pin of the second node. This time we want to check if the value of our global variable equals true. And, as we are in a condition again, we use the equality operator for this. Let's take a look at the event in the simulation mode. For this simulation, I choose the player mode, as I like to only see what players will see later in the game. In addition, I drag out a second view pane and select a property inspector for it. If we now select the variable state tab, we can see how variable values change while going through the simulation. On the first run through this area of the game, the player will see the node for the first visit. Later, they will only see the second node. We automatically get to the first visit node. When leaving the node, the variable value is changed to true. On a second run through, we now enter the consecutive visit node as the variable value is true when coming into the event. To wrap up things for this video, the quest needs to be set to completed after the quest node. Like before, we create an instruction in the output pin, setting the quest tracker variable to true. Our first mission is headed in the right direction, but is not quite finished yet. In the next video, we will create the surface of the moon as a location and connect specific areas with our mission objects. If you want to recap the steps we did so far in this project, just download the project files and open them with Articy Draft 3. The link can be found in the video description. Until next time, bye bye.